So, hi, I'm Sayan. I'll be talking on Bugyou. That's a project I've been working on for last few months. And it basically reports message from our infrastructure Fedora message, fedmsg. That's the Fedora infrastructure message bus. So, so who am I? I work as a senior software engineer with the Fedora infrastructure team. And that's my Twitter handle, GitHub, and my email ID. Before moving to Bugyou, I'd like to emphasize on what is fedmsg, because it's completely built on top of fedmsg. Fedmsg is a Python package that is built on top of zmq. So it is used within the infrastructure to receive and publish message across different applications. So all the application within the Fedora infrastructure basically communicates with using this fedmsg, Fedora infrastructure message bus. So this is a kind of old picture, but this gives a overview of what happens inside the fedmsg. So we have all the different applications pushing messages to the fedmsg bus. It uses the publish subscribe model of the fedmsg, and then we have a list of different applications that uses this messages to do various operations. So if you suppose if you know of data grepper, so whenever fedmsg pushes any message to fedmsg, so data grepper listens to all the messages and stores. So it provides a JSON API so that you can fetch all the messages and do any analytics over that. So this message bus is publicly subscribable, so you can subscribe, listen messages, and build applications on top of it. But you cannot push messages to it, right? So we have a flat file of which applications can actually push messages to the message bus, but you can actually subscribe to it and consume messages. So now that you have a some kind of a idea of what actually fedmsg is, so we can now move over to Bugyou. So Bugyou is a service that is built on top of fedmsg, and it listens to all the messages from fedmsg, and it's a combination of different plugins, and those plugins are actually doing the job of pushing, creating issues in different issue tracking services like GitHub, Pegyour. We are thinking to implement Track, Bugzilla, etc. So what was the motivation? So around last year in October, we were building a project called AutoCloud, which does automatic testing of those cloud images. So we have a nightly compose that runs every day. So AutoCloud, basically each compose sends a message that there has been a compose built. So AutoCloud basically listens to that particular message and it tries to test that particular image. Now the problem was that even though tests were getting failed, so AutoCloud does not have a notification system of its own. So it was very difficult to know when the test was failed and which all test failed. And suppose you lose track for 2 or 3 days, so if that test passed or not. So that's when we came with this idea that we should actually build a fedmsg, kind of a fedmsg issue tracking tool, so that actually we can create issues using this. So initially we only had Bugyou listen to AutoCloud messages and create issues into Pegyour. But later down the line, we thought this should be a generic application so that more and more plugins can be added in the future. So Bugyou is divided into five parts, and this is the basic flow of Bugyou. So Bugyou has Bugyou consumer, then it has a plugin queue, then it has different plugins that is called the Bugyou plugins, and then we have Bugyou services, and finally the Bugyou controller. So I'll go through each of this. So first the Bugyou consumer. So in the beginning, in the starting, you can see the Bugyou consumer, the fedmsg is listening to fedmsg and consuming all the messages, and then it's what it does is that it consumes the messages and then does a filtering on it. So we have a message filter. So it actually checks which all plugins are actually registered to Bugyou, and based on that, so each plugin has, so each of the plugin has its own topic filter, and so that consumer actually checks if that particular topic is matching the message topic or not, and if it's not matching, it simply discards that message, and if it's matching, then it passes, it sends that particular message to the plugin queue. Okay. So each of the plugin has its own plugin queue, which is there in Redis, and whenever there is a new message, so after the message passes through the message filter, it sends that particular message to each of the plugin queue, and we does not do any modification to the message. It simply passes that message to the message queue, plugin queue, and then we have our this complete Bugyou plugin. So these are different plugins that we have. For now, we had just have the AutoCloud plugin migrated to this complete new structure. So each plugin has its own plugin queue. So what is it does is that it listens to its own plugin queue, and whenever there is a new message, it takes that particular message and starts processing it. So whenever it receives a message, so we have a concept of services, right? So services are basically like the different issue tracking tools that we have. So suppose there's a Pegio service, GitHub service, track service, Bugzilla service. So we have methods like do Pegio, do GitHub, do Bugzilla, etc. So what it does, so whenever you are writing a new plugin, you need to override that particular method, and it basically the main plugin, what it does is sends to all of the different services method. So suppose you need to handle different messages separately. So suppose in Pegio you need to have a different title, in GitHub you need to add more information regarding that issue, so you can have different logic implemented in that particular method. So this AutoCloud plugin, basically the plugins actually does that particular job, and next we have the Bugyou services. So what we did was that we built an API on top. So we built an API on top of all the services like the Pegio or GitHub. GitHub is on progress. So basically this idea came from me when I was working on libcloud, and it had something like provider. So you change the provider, the API kind of the same, but you just need to like change the provider and the methods are just is same. So I tried to implement the same thing, that you just change the provider and you can use that particular method as it is. So like inside the Pegio do method, do Pegio, do GitHub methods, you can actually use those API and interact with your issue tracking services. And then this, using this Pegio service, you can push to Pegio or GitHub service, you can push to GitHub. So this is kind of the method flow which the message goes through, and finally the messages are created in Pegio. So the thing was that like now that AutoCloud has this complete feature, so since the issues are in public, so the issues can be directly like if you watch the particular repo, so you get notifications, and whenever there is a comment, so there is a option that the if that issue is already created, so it directly creates another comment that this failed again, or this message had been issued earlier. So the admins can actually see like if it has been failing for like 2-3 days, so action can be taken. Or since the issues are public, so new contributors or people who are managing it can actually comment over there directly and see why this is failing and why things are going wrong. So this is why, so this was another reason why we built Bugyou for that. So the main thing that we have is the Bugyou controller, which actually kicks in the complete process. So the fedmsg consumer is actually started by a fedmsg daemon that we have. It's known as the fedmsg hub, which actually kicks the process for consuming all the messages. But then this AutoCloud Bugyou plugin stuff, which is a separate repository we have with list of all the plugins, this actually is kicked by this Bugyou controller daemon we have written. So what it does is that whenever you start this particular service, so it pushes all the plugins registered to the an instruction queue, and this message filter, the Bugyou consumer actually keeps listening to this instruction queue, and whenever there is a new message, that there's a bunch of new plugins that have came, so it updates this its filter, so that next time when the filter, the messages are coming, so it can actually check those new plugins and push the message accordingly. So one thing, another benefit of having this was that even though you have to, like, whenever you are updating your plugins directory, so you can directly shut this off, but your queue will, so this will not get shut down, so it will keep pushing to your plugin queue, and whenever the message, when the this Bugyou controller kicks in, so it will again start consuming the messages. So to add new Bugyou plugins, you, so there's a CSG file we have, so it lists all the services you need to activate. So suppose you need to access Peggio or GitHub or Track, so it's comma separated, so services equals to Peggio comma GitHub comma Track, and then you have the topics which you need to listen to. So it's these are the fedmsg topics you need to listen. So these are currently comma separated and within the CSG file, but I am planning to move it to the plugin source code itself, so that you don't need to maintain a separate CSG file for this. And then we have this services. So basically, so to communicate with different issue tracking, you generally need to create a new application and have access token to it. So so there's a CSG file for Bugyou services where you need to name the auto the plugin name underscore the service name. And you can write all the repo name, all the access token, and the Peggio the Bugyou services will actually internally handle this, use this particular configuration and handle it in its code itself. So I'll go through the a quick walkthrough so that you can see, like, like this is the Bugyou consumer main consumer code. So if you see, every fedmsg is inherited by the fedmsg consumer. So each fedmsg consumer has a topic which you listen to. So here I am listening to all the topics so that I can, in the later step, I can actually do all the filtering. And then we have this in this line, that topic in self dot serve topic, that if this particular, this is basically the filtering process where the messages are getting filtered, and then we have a list of all the plugins it sends the message to, so it enqueues all the messages to different plugins. And so this is the AutoCloud plugin. So this is within the Bugyou plugins that we repo that we maintain. So this is a sample code. A lot of code has been truncated because I could not take a screenshot and show it in the same slide. So this is sample. It mostly contains all the things. So we have the plugin name in the top, which is actually used to get the data from the services configuration file. And then we have a process file which actually sends to all the services. And then here the method is doPeggio that actually uses those Peggio services and creates all the issues into Bugyou. So this is a basic, this is not a very big project and a relatively very new project. So we have been building on it, and so our in the future we are planning to add GitHub, GitHub is in progress, track Bugzilla, and so if you have any ideas, you can suggest. So this is kind of the end of the talk. These are the links which you can go through, the Bugyou read the docs is it's not the latest one. The latest doc is not pushed yet, but because the current work is still in staging, so we need to push it to production so that we can make it to the latest documentation. And the source code are Bugyou, which contains the consumer part, and the Bugyou plugins, which contains all the list of plugins. And one more thing is that to separate the services, Bugyou services, out of Bugyou plugins. Right now it's inside the Bugyou plugins repo, so we can directly move out of Bugyou plugins and provide a separate API so that people who are not using Bugyou plugins can also use that Bugyou services thing. And finally, fedmsg. Fedmsg is really good project, so if you want to go through, that's the link documentation. I think that was the quickest one.
That's not bad. That's a good comprehensive review.
Yeah.
Okay, so now you're starting with the
Bugyou,
right, okay, so that's where, so is there any way, and then you're going to build out a sort of a framework now for everyone to just be able to subscribe their service via the plugins?
Yeah, so whenever you need to add a plugin, so suppose Koji wants to interact with any Bugyou or GitHub services, so they directly write a plugin for it, and the plugin structure is the same. It should have a do Bugyou or a do GitHub method, and it will do all the process on its own. Yeah. So this is kind of still in very naive state, and I'm still, it was starting, I built it for AutoCloud. Typically Bugyou is built for AutoCloud, then it was to separate the complete thing so that people can reuse, so that it can be used in future. Yeah.
And then you're doing, so you have an automated test suite that's actually going out and verifying the images. That's what's basically going on here. So your QA is then reporting back to the,
yeah, so let me show you. Yeah. So the thing was that AutoCloud also took a major change. So we worked on it from April to June itself. I was working on the AutoCloud thing completely. So I don't know. Maybe I should mirror the screen. Okay, it's messed up here also.
Are
you using some kind of tiling for? No. Where is that? That is an ugly artifact. Okay. Yeah. So this is the thing, the AutoCloud project that we have. So each day you have the builds, and then if you go to the results, so this is related to each of the images that are tested. So this is yesterday or 2 days. Yeah, so today one thing failed, so you can directly visit the output.
Whoa, that's a new UI.
Yeah, we worked on it, it's completely new. Yeah, the thing was whenever the test fails, AutoCloud does not have a notification of its own. So we worked on Bugyou, and so that we have a repo which is kind of outdated now because the API. So it creates messages like this that a cloud background based background image field. So
yeah. So then if you've got something you want more specific after you in your triage, you can just fix the bug description and that.
Yeah.
But so you've got everything that was reported from the test.
Yeah. So this one actually is a bug in Tunis. This one. So. So
now I know exactly which test failed.
Yeah. And then I guess there's a page nightly.fedoraproject.org. Yeah, so this actually queries the auto cloud to get the messages, and you can have all the latest details about. Yeah.
What domain is that?
This is actually Adam's Adam's person, so he has done a redirect. Yeah. Yeah.
This code is inspired by StatsCache, right? But you were not able to use StatsCache?
No. So StatsCache, the code is inspired by StatsCache, but this has this services thing, right? So services thing cannot be integrated. At that point of time, we did not integrate Stats. Like StatsCache is basically built to like do all the analytics stuff and give a nice dashboard, like which all things failed and beautiful graphs. But and this is a completely different issue because we are dealing with bugs and issue tracking system. So we kept StatsCache and bug
separate.
Yeah. So we have a different project called StatsCache, which actually is also fedmsg consumer built on top of fedmsg, and it does all the analytics stuff for us. So
the standard test suite.
Basically, to keep. So what we used to do is that we used to have scripts that we used to pull developer, and developer is
very slow
because of the too much huge amount of writes happening.
Yeah.
So what we decided is that like we'll keep the data denormalized at point of when it originates. So there is a plugin that allows scripts on listening to that data and keeps on generating the updated analytics on top of that. So that data is always updated and it is read really fast. So we can easily use it for charting and all.
Yeah.
So
we have the.
We can have the because StatsCache and Bugyou has a lot of common patterns, right? It basically, how you extend plugins and all. We can have that in a common library.
Yeah.
So that logic of processing fedmsg message
so,
would be common.
Yeah. So that's why like Pingu last day told about that Python plugin, right? So.
Python plugin, is it?
Yeah, there's a package to manage plugins, so maybe we can leverage that to.
Yeah, because we need not do it ourselves.
Yeah.
That.
In that case, also we have a StatsCache plugin directory and repo, and we do the same thing like
almost
same thing. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, but you've got a slightly different.
Yeah.
Purpose.
Slightly
different. Yeah.
Slightly different goals.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense.
Maybe I should turn off this.
Are you getting